Think about all the cell phones that we have. Everybody tends to get a new phone every 1 to 2 years. And then you think about an electric vehicle, it's just a much larger form of electronics waste. What do we do with them at their end of life? Every piece of clean energy technology starts with critical minerals like cobalt, nickel, manganese. We need more of those metals to transition in the timeframe that we want to transition in and need to transition in to really move away from fossil to hit all of our climate goals in the near future. To do that, we need a better way to refine these critical minerals. We need to figure out that waste management solution so that we don't have massive landfills of these electronic components.
The world is changing its entire system for producing and using energy, attempting to replace the very base of the global economy, from fossil fuels to clean power sources. And with that has come a growing need for critical metals. These are the materials that go on to make everyday items that people have come to rely on, like smartphones and cars.
Nth Cycle is a metal refining technology company. So if we look at the existing refining technologies that are out there today, they're called hydrometallurgy, which is a really long word to say they use lots of solvents and acids to pull these metals out of these end of life and different ore bodies. Or they use pyrometallurgy, which is again a fancy word to say that they melt everything at very high temperatures. Those have very high carbon footprints. And we wanted to figure out a way to be able to pull these metals out with the same efficiency or even higher at a lower cost and with a much lower carbon footprint. And so with our technology, we can reduce the carbon emissions by up to 92% compared to traditional mining, and we can reduce the carbon footprint by up to 44% compared to traditional methods used in recycling.
This is the proprietary electroextraction cell, which will help collect all of the precious materials that we're trying to get out, like the cobalts and the nickels, into the product form that we want, and then we pull it out into a separate tank.
So I like to think of electroextraction at the highest level like a Brita water filter that you'd have in your home fridge. When you have your Brita filter, you put your tap water in it, and there's that activated carbon cartridge that you put in the top. That activated carbon filter takes out all the heavy metals that could be in your drinking water out in that one single stage. So we've taken that same basic idea of using a high surface area filter and filtering out water, but applying an electrical current across that carbon filter so that it selectively removes one metal over another.
So when we work with scrap facilities, for example, they will collect all of the batteries, like from your cell phones, your laptops, and then they will shred them into a material that's called black mass. And this is where all of the cobalt, the nickel, the lithium, and the manganese remain.
We dissolve it in a water-based solution. It goes through our many filter stages, each with a different electrical current across it, and it can pull out the cobalts from the manganese, from any of the other materials that are in there, and we pull them out in their metal powder form.
And this is the product on the other side.
Nth Cycle says its process has far lower greenhouse gas emissions than standard recycling methods. But like any new technology, deployment and use will be the true test. The recycling startup is also dependent on two types of demand: demand from people who have dead batteries and scrap, and demand for the recycled products. So while there's possibility for serious growth, it could be a bumpy ride.
This is a community that's not used to seeing innovation. They tend to be very slow moving and using the technology that they've used for hundreds of years. And for good reason, right? They always worked before. But as we move into this new energy economy, we need to start to rethink what that technology looks like. And so I think one of our biggest hurdles is really helping this community understand what we're doing, why we're doing it. The world of refining has always had these large centralized facilities because that was the only way to reach cost parity, to make the economics work. What Nth Cycle has done that's very different from what has been done in industry before is create a modular, distributed recycling and refining technology that can go on site with our customers, both in the recycling space and in the mining space, so that we can A, cut out transportation, the cost and emissions associated with that, and then meet the volumes of these feedstocks that we have at our disposal here in the Western world. Nth Cycle is currently at our commercial scale, which is a single unit that can process 3,000 metric tons of input per year. And scaling for us is simply adding modules in parallel. We'll always need more metals. You can think about critical minerals as the new oil. They are what sustains the clean energy economy. And so we needed to figure out a new way to refine these materials to create a world as sustainable as the one that we've always imagined.